City of culture and gateway to the world. Hi, I'm Noah, and I make videos exploring China. And today, I'm gonna introduce you to the most underrated city in China, my hometown of Ningbo. And as I just pointed to, it is first and foremost known as a city of culture, in particular, a culture of collecting the past. Which brings us to our first stop.
Tianyi Ge is the oldest private library in Asia and one of the three oldest family libraries in the world. And hey, I've been to a library or two in my day, but we're talking 300,000 ancient volumes of books, and it's got 80,000 of the rarest of the rare stuff. I mean, we're talking your great, 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 great grandfather's civil service examination. And hey, if you're thinking right now about clicking off this video because why in the heck should I care? Then you, my friend, do not understand that here in China, documentation is everything. And hey, I'll admit that my red, white, and blue ass doesn't understand it either. In the good old US of A, as long as Nicolas Cage doesn't try stealing the 250-year-old Declaration of Independence again, we're good. By contrast, the city of Ningbo has 7,000 years of history, and China altogether has about 4,000 years of written history. I bet somewhere within the first few thousand years, when China's the pinnacle of culture in the world, someone be saying, we better write this shit down. And that right there is the spirit of Tianyi Ge, the spirit of Ningbo, a symbol of the preservation and continuity of one of the world's greatest cultures. Another Ningbo fun fact is that the game of Mahjong originated here, and Tianyi Ge is the home of China's one and only Mahjong exhibition hall. Again, Ningbo is a city with 7,000 years of history, so we've only begun to crack the tip of the iceberg when it comes to Ningbo's past. You may then, however, be also surprised to learn that Ningbo is one of China's most modern cities as well. Laowaitan, the old Ningbo Bund. Historically, it's one of China's oldest and busiest ports, and it's my favorite place to visit Ningbo at night. If you're looking for some noise, if you're looking for a party, if you're looking to lose yourself in a crowd of people, don't come here, go to Shanghai. What I need in a city's nightlife is a place after a celebration, after a heartbreak, or just whenever I feel like it, to meditate on life, if you will, to remember the good, forget the bad, and just immerse myself in the heartbeat of the city. And Laowaitan's got exactly what I need. Located on the convergence of three rivers, Laowaitan's old-style architecture, combined with its futuristic backdrop, is eye-popping. And it's almost always quiet, full of plenty of open space to breathe in the Ningbo cityscape. And don't forget about the gorgeous Dongqian Lake. Dongqian Lake dates back 1,200 years and is four times the size of Hangzhou's West Lake, China's most famous lake. Through dynasties of intensive labor, this water system has been transformed into an irrigation reservoir that has ensured the plentiful abundance of food and crops year after year. It's one of the reasons this region of China has been named Fertile Land of Fish and Rice. And fish is delish, but I came here for the most beautiful view in all of Ningbo. You can't beat a sunset at Dongqian Lake.
We've delved into Ningbo's history, its nightlife, and its scenery. But now you're truly in for a surprise. What I'm about to show you is the most off-the-grid place I've visited in China. Together with my friend Russo, a local Ningboer, we're headed just off the coast of Ningbo to Daxie Island, a giant factory city.
I kid you not, it does look like a city. A nice city.
Yeah, it's out of like an anime or something.
You don't know how long it goes.
No.
They make oil here?
No, oil product.
How do you think this place is representative of Ningbo?
Ningbo used to be, it's still
is one of the biggest sports factories.
Russo isn't exaggerating. As unbelievable as it might seem, the annual cargo for the Ningbo Zhoushan port ranks first in the world. This isn't exactly the travel destination that I'd recommend friends to come and visit if they come to Ningbo. But I can genuinely say that Russo has taught me to appreciate this ginormous factory town, not just through his eyes, but through my own as well. One of the purposes for this channel has been to show you that China is more beautiful than is portrayed in Western media. However, I cannot evade the fact that Daxie Island is exactly what Western media portrays China to be. And yet the journey to explore here is just as remarkable as visiting one of my infamous Chinese ancient towns. Where else in the world could I be standing in front of a giant, fully functioning, yet practically empty factory city?
It's just stunning. Being the fact that, you know, such a big place and such a lit place, there's hardly you can see anyone inside or among these buildings. It's actually cool and somehow makes you feel alone, but peaceful.
Daxie Island is simply a tiny metaphor for the city of Ningbo, a hidden, bright, beautiful, and peaceful corner of the world. I am steadfast in my assertion that Ningbo is the most underrated city in China. You'll be hard-pressed to find it on the internet, rated as one of the top expat destinations for people to live in China. But it really should be. Its rich heritage, laid-back lifestyle, spectacular scenery, as well as its surprises, have completely won me over. I think maybe, just maybe, I'll stay a while.
For more on Ningbo, check out my Ningbo challenge videos. And I'll see y'all for the next great China adventure.